Hey guys, my name is Lam and welcome to our new channel,
Daddy Wants to Dinner.
And in this program, we are going to cook all kinds of food and feed all kinds of people. Today, we are going to feed our family. Oh, I forgot to introduce to you. This is my son and his name is Lenny. He's going to be my assistant today. So, we are going to cook beef chili burritos today. Let me introduce the ingredients to you, or maybe my son can introduce.
Okay, so there's a four bean mix. It was bought from some supermarket. We need some tomato puree. We need ground black pepper.
We will need beef.
Oh yeah. Oh yes, right. Beef.
Beef chili, of course. Minced we need beef. Beef. And what kind of vegetables are these?
We have capsicum, some chilies, and two onions.
And onions. Mm-hmm. How about the spices? What kind of spices do we need?
We have black pepper, there's sugar.
Sugar.
We have
oregano, herb.
Yep.
And do you know what kind of herbs these are?
Is it called star anise?
Star anise and cumin seeds. So these are all the things we will need to prepare the beef chili. Let us begin by preparing the vegetable. First, let's chop up the capsicum. The good thing about preparing your vegetable in the garden is this, that you can immediately compost all the parts that you do not use. Like this part of the capsicum, just push it in and cut it out. You can just throw it there and let it compost. Let's cut up the other part. Okay. Lenny, would you like to cut the vegetables for me?
Okay, sure.
Okay, let me show you how the vegetable is cut. Okay, just cut them into long strips. And chop them into smaller cubes. Can you do that?
Okay, sure.
Next, let me prepare the onion. Come closer and we will see how we should chop up the onion. You chop up the onion by first slicing it this way. Then, cut it this way. Now you can just chop and it will be in small pieces. This is how you chop the onions. Finally, let's chop up the chili. Chili is going to give some kick to the beef chili. After all, it's called beef chili. We shall now open up our cans of mixed beans as well as tomato puree. Okay, let's do it, man. You would open the can and I'll. So we should drain out the water in this mixed
mixed bean. Right, so I'll drain it out now. Drain out. How are you doing, Danny?
Okay.
I think I should help you cut it wrongly. Press it in half. Now let's start cooking. Let's heat up the pan. You would like the fire to be at full blast when you are heating it up. I prepared about half a kilogram of minced beef. I'm not going to use any oil because the minced beef that you obtain from the supermarket is already oily. And so as long as we fry them on a non-stick pan, it should work. It's sizzling immediately because of its oil content. As you can see, if you are using a good non-stick pan, you do not need to put any additional oil into your dish, in this dish. Alright, I'd like to add some of the spices, starting with brown pepper. Okay, to be generous, we got ground pepper. It's going to add a lot of fragrance to your chili. A teaspoon of sugar. Perhaps two. Your star, Annie. Throw it in. And a teaspoon of cumin. I also like to add some oregano herbs. Keep frying. At this point, you can add your vegetables in. Throw in your chopped capsicum, chopped onions, and chili, and fry them together. It's beginning to smell nice. Okay, new ingredient. As I was looking at the dish, I thought it is not spicy enough. So I'm going to add some chopped chili, chili powder. Right, I hope that will spice it up. Continue to fry. I think it's time to add the other ingredients. The two cans of a can of mixed bean. Pour it in now. And just now, as I was looking at my beef chili, I thought it was too dry, so I added another can of tomato puree. Let's take a look at how it should look like. This is how it should look like, the consistency is like that. Right, and now you can turn down the fire and put it to slow boil for about an hour. And in an hour, our beef chili should be ready.
You would also need to cook some basmati rice, or what some people understand as long grain rice. So I have here for myself some high quality basmati rice. The thing about basmati rice is that it is more fluffy and it has less gluten in it. So I guess it is more healthy. And of course, it is the kind of rice that you should use for making burritos. Pour about 1 cup of rice into a bowl. If you want to eat more, you can always cook more. And wash it thoroughly. Do you know that the water that you use to wash rice is very good for plants? Like, so just squeeze the rice this way. You can see the water turning cloudy. It's getting rid of some of the dirt. But this rice is by itself already quite clean. So let me use the water to water the plants. Plants are feeling very happy now. So we should not cook it immediately. Soak it in some more water for about an hour. And cook it only after 1 hour. It will be more fluffy that way. It's been 1 hour. I believe our beef chili is ready. I've also cooked our basmati rice for about 15 minutes. If you are cooking 1 cup of rice, you need about 1.5 cup of water. Right, just 15 minutes. If you have soaked your basmati rice properly, you just need 15 minutes and the basmati rice will be ready. So let's come over and take a look at our chili.
And this is how the chili should look like after 1 hour of slow fire cooking. Doesn't it look delicious? And let's take a look at the basmati rice. I'll show you how fluffy it is. Right? It's nice, fluffy basmati rice.
The rice and the chili ready, we can now assemble our burrito. Just buy from your supermarket a pack of wraps like that. If you have a wrap, this is how we assemble. You will need also some cheese and some cilantro. First, lay some basmati rice on the wrap. Add some of this nice spicy chili.
Then top it up with cheese, shredded cheese. You can use any kind of shredded cheese. I'm using mozzarella here. Lots of it. And finally, top it up with some chopped cilantro. Just wrap it up. Ooh, I put too much ingredient, but I don't think anybody will mind that we serve them fat and thick burrito, right? Okay.
Lenny will now add some coleslaw to our plate and we'll be ready for dinner.
Be more generous, just put more. Vegetable is good for you.
Great. And perhaps we should just pop it up with a little more cilantro. Just to make it beautiful. And so that's our dinner for tonight. Burrito, beef chili burritos. Let us all give thanks for the food. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for giving us the gift of Jesus Christ. And Lord, we thank you for the gift of family, and we thank you for the food on the table. We pray and ask that you will help us not just enjoy the food, but also enjoy each other as a family. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Okay, come, let's try it. And give me your honest review.
How is it, Lenny?
It's good. Bunny more chili.
Oh, you like it to be more spicy?
Tabasco.
Oh. We have Tabasco sauce.
Yeah.
You can add it. How about my darling wife? How do you find the food?
It's good. It's good. I need to work on my vocabulary.
How about my two other children?
Nice.
Just nice?
Yeah.
Okay, we have to work on our vocab, really.
But it's not spicy at all.
I thought it's quite spicy.
Spicy, yeah.
Okay.
Alright, that's all for today, and hope you enjoy the burrito, the deep chili burrito, as much as you did. Even though you can't taste it, but I guess you can imagine how nice it must be. So, try it someday with your family, and thank you for watching.
Daddy, where's the dinner?
Okay, cheers, cheers everybody, cheers. Cheers.